happening now. New Year's shutdown. Wolf Blitzer is off. I'm Brianna Keeler. This is a Situation Room special report. It's New Year's Eve and day 10 of the government shutdown. President Trump is again home alone for the holiday. He began his celebration with a Twitter tirade, contradicting his outgoing chief of staff by saying he never abandoned the idea of a concrete border wall. We have CNN Justice correspondent Jessica Schneider joining us now. Was Manafort compromised? That's the question. He was certainly vulnerable to it.
Right, and that's probably the key question here that Mueller's team is now investigating, especially because of all the timing in this, Brianna.
If your baseline is reopening the government, the short answer is probably not, right?
To the media. And it's not the first time there has been this public disconnect between John Kelly and the president. You'll recall last year when John Kelly went on, I believe, Fox News and said the president's views were evolving on immigration, and because he knows it's a buzzword for his base. He needs the base to believe that he is behind building this wall.
You about Paul Manafort, because there's this report out in Time magazine that he, while he was campaign chairman for the Trump campaign,
oh, nobody on the Trump campaign either knew or cared that Paul Manafort was so vulnerable to manipulation.
He demeans her, name calls her, and everyone else. It's just most unfortunate.
Sam, I wonder, as someone who observes international relations, when you see President Trump questioning really her authenticity, whether she has Native American heritage, even still, as she has proven that she does with a DNA test, it seems like it's a trick we've seen before in some foreign elections, questioning the authenticity, questioning if people say who they are. What do you think?
I don't think President Trump is really in a position to be questioning anybody pretending to be something that they're not or their qualifications for office.
His using, Phil, a racial slur when he calls her Pocahontas, you know, he's using that pejoratively, is something that took hold. I mean, she had to address this, so she's had to respond to it.
Yeah, I think, one, that this was the most predictable response from the president that you could have ever imagined. I mean, I remember reporting on meetings, private coming. How is Senator Warren planning to respond, and how are Democrats going to respond in general? There's always the debate of, do you get in the fight with him? Do you have a full-blown fight, a Marco Rubio-esque fight, if you want to harken back to 2016, or do you try
potential contenders handle this? Because as you point out, Marco Rubio tried to get down the mud with him as well, and it didn't work out so well for him either.
I wonder, in this, there are a number of times where President Trump and candidate Trump has done something, and you look at it and you say, that's not going over well.
But
it's so pointless.
There's just a lot of time left, and so I think a lot of people are going to be
We just want to know. We have some time
crystal
ahead
ball.
Of us. Thank you, all of you. I appreciate it.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to all of you.
Thank you.
Tight security and a soggy forecast.